Also, what happens and happened tragically in the case of Anthony Minghella is that he died unexpectedly in 2008, in the spring of 2008, as a result of an operation where we all expected him to recover very well, and a week later he had died. And I was in Argentina at the time working on Tetro and heard the news. My son had been looking online and suddenly saw this news that Anthony had died. And I made arrangements as soon as possible, flew back to London from Argentina to be at his memorial service. But I absolutely not only enjoyed, but it was a deeply rewarding experience working with Anthony. And I had kind of assumed, because Anthony was 10 years younger than me, that this is it. You know, I would just continue, that I would die first, and we would continue working together on film after film. And it was not to be. And, you know, looking back at my the films that I worked on, I can see the from a distance the shock of that, and the repercussions of that, in a sense, over the last, well, it's been 8 years since he died, and I still think he's still here. You know, it's all too frequent. Reaction to the death of somebody, especially somebody younger than you, that with whom you have a deep creative relationship. So it's a very sad thing in my working experience, and I've never, it's the first and only time that I've experienced that. And I'm still, part of me is still trying to figure it out.